Hello, I'm RJ.
Hey, how you doing?
I'm doing wonderful, just hanging out in my kitchen. I wanted to start off by thanking you for a beautiful movie. I know I've seen other people write about this, but it's so nice to see joy right now.
Yeah.
And to see people like in a room together. So that was nice. But I guess sort of segueing naturally into that, there's this parallel between Mangrove and Lover's Rock. People seeing Mangrove as more political, but I saw Lover's Rock as political too, in the sense that it celebrates joy for Black people. Is that something you agree with, or do you see it as political too?
Yeah, I understand you with that one, especially because the whole thing with this, with these Lover's Rock, with these blues nights, is that this was the Black community coming together to celebrate the Black culture because they weren't allowed in the white nightclubs. And this was them celebrating anyway and celebrating our culture despite that. So yeah, I do agree with you on that one.
Yeah. And like I said, the joy is palpable. And then you have to sort of wonder, if was that parallel when you're actually shooting it? Because I know a lot of these scenes are, you know, probably a lot more silent than we think they are, you know, when they're being shot.
What was nice, there was quite a lot of moments where we had the music.
Oh, okay.
Really feeling it, and we got to work with an incredible choreographer called Coral, who really got us to understand about energy and where the energy is held, and it's heavy in the feet, and it's, you're connected to the earth, you know. And she worked with the supporting artists because I think they're really key in this. And she got them in a room before filming. She said, I can't just have them in costume and go on set, they need to understand this energy. And she got the music blazing and worked with them for a while. So I remember first walking onto set and seeing everyone in costume and seeing just everyone living it. And I was like, wow, this is really like what my parents were talking about those times. This is how it was. It was, and what you're seeing on screen, that no one is faking that. Everyone was feeling it. And it was just so beautiful.
Yeah, that's really interesting, because I think what the movie sort of goes for is like, you're just a fly on the wall, or, you know, you're at the party, right? And so it felt like everybody just kind of stumbled into the room, which was nice. So your character is very, you know, she has a kind heart, she's sweet, but she's also really guarded, which I think is sort of really like a reflection of the party at large, right? The party is really fun, but then there's these white characters who are outside, you know, making monkey noises and stuff like that. What were your conversations with Steve about, you know, developing this character? How did you sort of approach it?
So with me, I think the first thing I done was research the time. And from there, I was able to discover Martha's likes, her dislikes, her opinions, who her inspirations are, her like favorite color, like things like that. And then I think just speaking more with Steve, he was just very much about you bringing your truth to it, and how you feel with it. And I mean, I more spoke with my mum than anything, because my mum came from Jamaica when she was 9, you know? So to get to speak with her and hear little stories about her life, and my dad, who was a reggae artist, hear things with him. I think with Steve, he was just so open and trusting that it was very much about what you're bringing to it, as long as you are staying true to his beliefs too. He was very much all for openness.
Yeah, I love that. And I think it comes through. This is so, maybe a silly question, but you know, the movie ends and you know, you're with your co-star Michael, and I kept thinking, I would love to see more of this story. Yeah. I'm like, I'm assuming there's no plans, obviously, to do more, but I don't even have a question. I'm like, can we just do it again?
It'd be lovely to see what happens next with those two, but there's nothing at the moment as far as
yeah, I know it's
it to the imagination. I've seen a review that says, does he call her, does he, you know? It's nice to kind of leave that to the imagination as well.
Yeah, it's also lovely that part where it's like time for church, I'm like, oh Lord. I know that feeling.
That one, yeah, it was just beautiful, beautiful time filming it. It was beautiful to see it and see what we created. Steve is a genius. The whole cast was incredible. I was very lucky to work with the people that I worked with, and I pray that the next job is just as incredible.